Again, welcome back. Again, my objective in making this series of videos is to empower you. I want you to understand. I want you to believe that for you to eat healthy, you do not have to become a chef. It doesn't have to be complicated, and it will be actually easy. When it comes to me, I dance with my food. Yes, I have the power. I have the power, and I want you to have the exact same power. Today, we're going to do something very unique. I know you are busy. You've seen the instant pot in here. We'll talk about legumes. Legumes should be part of your nutrition. Legumes are basically lentils, beans, soy. Beans, you have black bean, pinto bean, navy bean, beans. You have a whole bunch of beans out there. And usually people will say, oh, but I do not digest them. The reason why you cannot digest them is because you do not have the enzyme to digest them, and you can get them. So the way you do it is you start introducing the beans in your life very, very slowly. Day one, have only a tablespoon for 1-2 days, and then 2 tablespoons for 1-2 days, and then 3. By the end of 2-3 weeks, you'll be able to digest the beans, and they are delicious. Today, we are going to see what we can do with the Instant Pot and beans. Here, in this Instant Pot, I have made a pot of beans, and very simple. 1 cup of the white beans, 1 cup of the pinto beans, 1 cup of the red beans, 1 cup of the black beans, 1 onion, 2 cups of tomato that I get from Trader Joe's, 1 cup of shredded carrot, 1 cup of shredded celery, 10 cups of water. That's it. You put it in your Instant Pot, and you have a choice, okay? You can go on the slow cook for the Instant Pot, or you can go on to the manual one. Manual one, you put 25 minutes. So here is what you get. What I want to do today is by telling you that you can make 3 different dishes with this one. Who wants to eat a pack of chili like that the whole time? You want variety. So, the first thing we're going to do is, I call it the Moroccan style. One, two, three, four, of it, okay? And I'm using the Ninja today because I don't want too much noise and the beans are already cooked. So, with it, my Ninja, if I can position it correctly. Très bien. That's it. So, what do you do with this one in here, the Moroccan style? Because I said Moroccan style of beans, I will use some lemon juice. Remember, when I'm making my videos, I don't give you measurement, because at the end of the day, it is about the pleasure trap. It is about pleasure. And the pleasure, by the way, comes from the pleasure in your food. You know how you get them? With your spices. Voila. You see? Plenty of spices, and you can turn the food that has absolutely no taste into a delicacy. So today, we're going to make 3 delicious meals with beans. So again, back here. So what do I do? I'll put a little bit of lime juice because I want it the Moroccan style. I will put some cumin. You see, a little bit of cumin. Some oregano. Those are dry oregano from my garden. A little bit of thyme. Voila. You mix the whole thing. And a little bit of paprika. Voila. And a little bit of peppercorn. Voila. You mix the whole thing. Ooh la la, it looks good, isn't it? I love paprika. And now you're going to put some salt in it. I have here Himalayan salt. Just a little bit, a pinch. Très bien. You have here a soup. I call it my Moroccan style soup with beans. Remember the sour cream that we made? So I'll serve it with a dash of sour cream in top. Look at that. And if I want to be fancy like my friend Bibi, I'll just do this with the paprika. Look at this. Where is my husband when I need him to be my taster? Oh, this is good. Good. So this is one way of eating your pot of beans. The second way of eating it, I call it the Indian style for my and the Kenyan style, actually, from my friend Loretta. She taught me how to do that. I saw her do that one day and I'm like, oh, that's kind of cool. So what you do, again, exact same base. This is for the demo here. Okay. You add in there some pepper. I have here red, yellow, and orange pepper. No green pepper because I do not like it. Remember, the pleasure trap. It's about pleasure. I don't like green pepper. I don't put green pepper in it. You like green pepper, put your green pepper in it. A little bit like that. And it's fresh because I know I am not going to eat it today. So when I warm it up later on, the red pepper will cook. Okay. And now the seasoning for this one in here is with curry. Here is the curry. So you put as much curry as you like in there. In this house, we love curry. So we put plenty of curry, and I love to have a little bit of garlic in that. So fresh garlic, I dress it. Voila. You mix the whole thing. Oh, la, la. And of course you need some basil. And I also like to use the 21 seasoning salute from Trader Joe's. It has a different seasoning in there, a little bit. And again, remember, it is your food. You want more basil, add more basil. You want more garlic, add more garlic. And then I am going to salt it. Voila. And here you go. You have what I call my Kenyan style beans. Oh la la, delicious. With the same beans, you can make chili. Oh, by the way, I won the second place of chili with just this. So I'll serve it here so you can see it as it goes. chili, I have one secret. I use smoked paprika. You see, this is just paprika, the first one that I use, but this one in here is smoked. And in my house, my husband loved smoked paprika. So I'm going to put plenty of smoked paprika. Why? Because we like it this way. You cannot do chili without cumin. So a little bit of cumin. If you don't like cumin, don't put on it. I have a girlfriend who cannot stand cumin. I love cumin. We put it in there. And of course, some coriander. And you don't do chili without basil or cilantro. Here are some basil, very generous set of basil. I use them usually fresh because I have some basil in my background in here. And no chili without chipotle. So some chipotle. Okay. And no chili without jalapeno pepper. So jalapeno pepper, you see, I kept the seed in mind because in this house we can eat hot. But if you cannot eat hot, spicy, remove the seed. A little bit on that, it gives a different kinds of flavor to it. I'm hungry already. You can stop here, okay? Now, the second secret from my chili is the smoked sauce, salt. Smoked sauce. Oh, this makes a big difference in the chili. So a little bit of smoked, too much maybe here, of smoked salt. Oh la la, this is, c'est tellement bon. Now you can even go an extra mile with your chili. You can add in there some tempeh that I get from Trader Joe's. Voila, I call it the works now. Okay, and you can also add in some mushroom. So I have a portobello mushroom in here, shiitake mushroom. I make them sweat. In French we say, on les fait pleurer, you make them cry. But I don't like it to make them cry, so I like to say I make them sweat. So they don't have any more of the water in it. So I take a little bit of my mushroom in there, mix the whole thing. This is the works. How do we eat it in this house? We eat it with, remember this plate? Small part in here, rice. The biggest part of my plate is going to be anything vegetables. So today I have some beets. Beet is my new, beet leaves are my new kale. You see? And then my chili. Doesn't it look delicious and healthy? My heart is already saying, oh yeah, I'm getting some copper, I'm getting some iron, and it is going to be delicious. Look at this. So here, with the same big batch of beans, you have made a bean soup, which taste is entirely different from what I call my Kenyan beans, and of course from the chili. All this based on the spices that you are using. It's about the spices, dummy. It's the title of my next book. So how do you do that best again? Whatever beans you like. In this case in here, I use 1 cup of the navy beans, 1 cup of the pinto beans, 1 cup of the kidney beans, 1 cup of the black beans, 1 onion,
2 cups of tomato, the crushed tomato from Trader Joe's. 1 cup of shredded carrots and 1 cup of shredded celery. Let me stop in here and give you more power. Anytime a recipe calls for broth, vegetable broth, based on the recipe, what I do is I take carrots and celery and I shred them and I put them in there. The benefit is I get the broth, but I also get the fiber. Et voilà! You see how easy it is to make? I wish you the very best, and we're going to see you next time.